everybody. Welcome to the Stan Sheriff Center, the Hawaiian Tel FCU starting lineup. Scrolling at the bottom of your screen, the Rainbow Warriors at 6-1. 1-1 in the MPSF, getting back into conference play, taking on UC San Diego, 3-5, 0-4 in the MPSF. And Hawaii's Jennings Franciscovich serving first to get things started. And it's a quick point for Hawaii as Alec Flowers hits it into the twine.
And the Tritons trying to establish their middle. A nice pass from Howard in the backcourt, but into the cable it goes.
Tritons coming off of a two-win season where they went 0-22 in the MPSF, but six returning starters from last season's team. As Ian Colbert is rudely welcomed to Honolulu by that big Hawaii block.
And the 6'2 junior has been carrying his team. Look to him to get a lot of opportunities this evening.
Sinki Zarkovich along with Hendrick Mole. In on that block, here's Franciscovich with the serve once again. Outside, it goes to Tanner Siftestad, and he's able to pull the string, and it works for UC San Diego's first point.
Well, at 6'8", you'd think that he would unload on that ball, but the big boy goes up, and nice, smart shot high up and over the block.
Manoa Leahy and Lisa Strandma'a here courtside for this volleyball match under the Friday night lights of the Stan Sheriff Center. Good serve by Colbert. And it'll be a free ball coming the way of the Tritons. Milos Stojcic sets middle to Flowers, and he's now gone into the net twice, and it's a freebie for the Rainbow Warriors.
And you know, some great defense, an opportunity lost. Again, that's his second into the net. Just a little misconnect in the middle. The timing just not right just yet.
So here is Siki Zarkovich, who has firmly implanted himself in Hawaii immortality as one of the members of the 1,000 Career Kill Club. Surpassed that in the last match against Grand Canyon. Stein von Tilburg is dug up, left side set. That goes to Josh Schmidt. Little pitter-patter at the net, and a net violation will be called against Hendrick Mole for Hawaii. So that's a point for the Tritons. Josh Schmidt, an interesting story for UCSD, 6'3 junior from Mission Viejo, California, who didn't play at all until sets 4 and 5 of UCSD's last win against Princeton on Wednesday, and he had 10 kills, came up clutch in some really key moments, and now he's out there getting the start as Hendrick Mole absolutely hammers that set in the middle.
Well, I love the story, and I have to agree with you more. Josh Schmidt did a great job against Princeton, came in, gave his team a lot of spark. Let's get back to Hendrick Mole on that last play. He had a fabulous warm-up. I'll tell you what, his connection in the middle was solid in warm-ups tonight.
Four serving two, Mole unable to connect on the serve though, 6'6 junior from Norway.
Playing a new position, you know, you gotta remember, he was an outside hitter and an opposite, and now he's been thrown into the middle.
So three serving four, and here's the serve from Tanner Siftestad, one of the team captains, and he sends it long. Interestingly enough, the other co-captain is the other guy in the lineup named Tanner Howard, the libero for UCSD.
They got the Tanner squared going as their co-captains.
Von Tilburg, the freshman out of the Netherlands, forces the overpass. Great job by keeping that one alive by Tanner Howard. And then past the triple block, Siftestad's dug up over the net by Kanetake. Siftestad again from the back row, and he's able to plug it by that proposed block. Ian McKellar was up next to Kupono Fei, and it's a point for the Tritons, down just one.
And just the net, the set was tight, but UH's block was a little ill-formed. They just left enough room for that ball to sneak in between them.
Schmidt again with the serve, knuckleballer, forcing the overpass by Kanetake. Somewhat uncharacteristic error by Kanetake, but the block fixes everything as it was all three of the frontline players for Hawaii in on that one.
And that was read like a book. Three blockers up, the triple block low and tight. I'm not sure how much of that truly cleared on the replay as we just saw.
Jennings Franciscovich, the setter at 6'5", who touches 12 feet. Getting the gist of that one. Now Kupono Fei, the local boy, with the serve. Siftestad from the back row right there. To spoon it up is Kobe Kanetake. Now Zarkovich down Kalakaua Avenue for the point.
And Zarkovich doing a great job to set a little bit off the net. Here on the replay, you can see he sneaks a peek. The block gives him, goes right between the middle hands of Shane Beamer.
So 7 serving 4. A little burst here by Hawaii in the early stretch of this opening set. And Kupono Fei, the 6'5 junior out of Punahou, with the serve. Set outside, rising high as Colbert dug up back over the net and just misses the court wide. So it's a point for UCSD. But did you see the springs on the junior from Belmont, California, Ian Colbert?
Well, you said it just right, rising high. He is 6'2", and he can fly. He is really, really going to be fun to watch tonight.
Shane Beamer sporting the headband with the run-up serve. He's got 3 aces on the season. Ian McKellar didn't get a good swing on it. So Schmidt from the back row tried to go hard angle and misses wide. Disaster averted for Hawaii there.
And again, Schmidt, 6'3", outside heater, a junior, transferred in from Irvine Valley. Familiar friend of ours, coach there, Tom Pestalozzi, must have been his coach, I'm assuming.
Here is now Ian McKellar, the junior from England, 6'7" with the southpaw serve. Flowers that time got it over the net, but Hawaii with the touch, and Hendrick Mull able to make good use of it. Largest lead of this first set at 9-5 for Hawaii.
Hendrick Mull just low and tight to the net with a great block, and then plays very aggressively at the net.
You got 2 players who have transitioned to that middle this season for Hawaii. McKellar, the other one who is serving. Colbert, triple block was up, but right there to clean it up was Howard, so still a chance here for the Tritons. And Siptestad able to somehow split that double block proposed by Hawaii for another Tritons point.
Well, one of the things that's happening on Hawaii's side of the net is they are blocking very, very well, and the defense is lined up, and every once in a while you're going to get one that does go down. This ball is being hit hard.
Served by Miloš Stojčić. He's the setter for UCSD. Zarkovic, he's dug up two-handed style by Howard. Schmidt didn't get all of it. Oh, busting out the spatula was Kanetake. Great second touch by Franciskovic. In the middle, that's Flowers. Diving save again, Kanetake. Von Tilburg, net violation call against the Tritons, and Hawaii gets the point. And how about the effort as Charlie Wade gives us a little peek. He's got the broken left arm. He says, I got to do the one-hand clap for that one.
I'll tell you what, some fabulous defense by the Warriors. They are sprawling out all over the place. The Tritons really tipping the ball and making the defense scramble.
Saw a reason why Kanetake is 6th in the nation in digs per set. Got another one there and a great second touch by Fed. Free chance for UCSD. Right side, they go to Colbert, and that time it was too hot to handle, even for the great Kobe Kanetake.
Colbert just getting up there and hammering that ball down the line, but you've got to give Howard, the defender on the Tritons team, some great credit. His passing has been on target.
Here is Colbert. Career high, 19 kills, 11 digs in that 5-set win over Princeton on Wednesday. Outside Von Tilburg, that's dug up by Howard. We got 2 very capable liberos in this one. But that one smacked along by Josh Schmidt. Remember, playing in his just 2nd match of the season and making his first start of his UC San Diego career.
And most likely in front of the biggest crowd, honestly, that he's probably ever played. He earned it. He's getting the opportunity. Maybe a little nervous still yet.
Served by Zarkovic, right side. This is Siptestad, misses wide, and it's a point for the Rainbow Warriors. They're up a handful. Timeout taken by Kevin Ring, the 11th year head coach for the Tritons. Some opportunities missed for UCSD early. Hawaii by 5. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the Kaiser Permanente keys to the match. Lisa.
Well, I went with pass, and according to Kevin Ring, he and I were on the same page because he said we have got to pass our first ball to stay in this match. Hawaii is a very tough serving team. And for Hawaii, I just say they've got to just stay focused. They're on their home court. They're trying to establish their middles. They're trying to find the balance. And each time out, they're trying to be a better team.
Hawaii hitting 400 here throughout this first set. UCSD negative 048. Right side set, that's Siptestad. Good touch by that Hawaii block. Now it's Kupono Fei. The block was up and it was tight for the Tritons. Siptestad able to turn the table, just a sophomore transfer from Chico State.
Siptestad played, look at that low and tight block for Chico State on a club team, and he is the tallest player on the court this evening at 6'8".
Yeah, Chico State doesn't sponsor a men's volleyball program, so he played club, which helped his eligibility-wise. for UCSD. Faye taking a little something off. Back row set. That's Colbert. Right back at you, says Hendrick Moll.
Just pitcher perfect at the net, low and tight, completely stretched over. This is textbook, if you will, folks. If you take a look at that cam, you gotta love it.
Hendrick Moll played just 12 matches last year, one start, sat out the last 7 matches of the year due to a left eye infection, which actually threatened his career. As you see the connection with Shane Beamer for UC San Diego, there were some thoughts that Hendrick Moll would not be able to continue his playing career with Hawaii. But fortunately for him, he has regained at least a slight amount of vision, about 5 to 10% of vision capacity in his left eye. He can see peripherally, he says, but nothing from the middle portion of that eye, as you see Ian McKellar, the other middle, putting it down.
And, you know, going to Hendrick Moll really quickly on his eye situation, he spoke at the fundraising event that they had for the team on Sunday night, and he is just so grateful to be out there again, and he does not have, his vision is so slighted, as you're sharing. It's amazing that he's still playing.
And contributing in the way that he is.
Exactly.
And good ad lib at the net that time by Miloš Stojčić, the 6'3 sophomore from Redondo Beach. It was a bit of an overpass, but he was still able to make it work for Trent's point.
He is front row. He is the setter for the team, so he is allowed to do that in the front court.
We saw McKellar quickly raising his hands to his forehead. He knows that he mistimed that potential joust. Serve goes out, though, and Hawaii reaches 15 first. Once again, up by a handful, 15-10, Rainbow Warriors.
OC Sports, presented on Oceanic Time Warner Cable, is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii. Kaiser Permanente. And Strong.
Let's check out the series record sponsored by Aston Hotels and Resorts, lopsided in the direction of Hawaii, 49-4. The last meeting was last season. You see, UCSD actually took Hawaii to 4 sets on March 28th. The serve out of the timeout by Kuponofe. 15-10, Hawaii in front, and there's the smackdown by Shane Beamer, which will better UCSD's previously flatline percentage hitting-wise as a team.
They just got back up at 0%, but Shane Beamer with that kill brought them into the positive.
Hawaii hitting 286 by contrast. The pass by Kanetake high, and away the set goes to Zarkovic, pounding it off the high hands and down.
Zarkovic for his second kill on the evening, 2 for 2 so far.
Averaging 4.3 kills per set. He's second on the team there. And he is third in the MPSF, 8th in the nation in kills per set. Enjoying his senior campaign. It looks like he, as you can tell by our shot there, it looks like he's enjoying himself. Good pass that time by Colbert. Right side, it's Siftestad. And he's going to get the point and the side for the Tritons.
And Siftestad in his 9th attempt. That's his 4th kill so far. He is in the positive, hitting at 333 so far this evening.
Averaging 2.24 kills on his end. And the run-up serve by the setter, Stojčić. Franciskovic sets up Von Tilburg from the back row, and he puts it down. A Stein von Tilburg, who's bettering his teammate Zarkovic by mere decimal points in the kills per set category, 4.61, which is good enough for tops in the MPSF and 4th in the nation. Yeah, he's a freshman.
It's crazy. His international experience, he does not play like a true freshman.
Flowers able to work it through that Hawaii block. So trading blows here at this middle stage of set one.
And the Tritons seem to be passing the ball fairly well. Hawaii has only one service ace so far in this match.
Colbert coming off of that double-double performance against Pritsit, his first of his career. Here's Zarkovic. The roof was up, courtesy Josh Schmidt.
And Josh Schmidt, known right now for his team as the guy that brings the energy, sealing the deal, really closing in on Zarkovic for a great block and their 14th team point.
Ask Kevin Ring, how on earth did this guy only debut this season in the last match with the way he played and the numbers he put up? He said, well, we don't necessarily see him play that way in practice. It was one of those situations where we put him out there, and as it turned out, per his previous experience, he was a bit of a gamer and came through in some tight spots in a hard-fought five-set win as Zarkovich was able to pull the string for a Hawaii kill.
And isn't that amazing, though? You think sometimes when opportunity knocks, he got the opportunity, and again, he took it in practice. Maybe he wasn't doing it. But according to Coach Ring, he said their game three against Princeton, they just were not good at all. Things were not happening, and he had to make a change. So he went with Schmidt, and there and behold, he found a starter.
The traverses of a season in college volleyball. Another pass there by the libero, Howard. In the middle, Flowers is dug up. Now Zarkovich from the back row went over a triple block, diving dig by Colbert. Bump set goes to Schmidt from off the net, and he curls it over the Hawaii triple block. And down. So Schmidt, who had those 2 years' experience at Irvine Valley College, showing a very veteran finesse type of stroke.
Well, you know, the set a little bit off. He sees three blockers, and he just goes for a deep corner shot for a kill. You don't have to hit it hard to get a kill, folks. You just have to see the court well.
Von Tilburg blocked, saved by Kanetake. Von Tilburg, a little stutter step approach. So chance now for UCSD. The tip by Siftestad. Sniffed out by Kanetake. Now Von Tilburg, the dink. That's punched up by Schmidt. Siftestad. That one hit the antenna, and that's going to be a Hawaii point. But we're not seeing aesthetically beautiful or pleasing volleyball here in the last few stretches, Lisa.
No, we're not. And it's interesting because earlier in the matches that I've actually watched, it seemed like Hawaii had a quicker tempo to the outside. Tonight, it's a little bit higher on the outside. Give the Tritons credit, man. They're passing well, and they're playing good defense.
Frederick Mole with the serve. Right side, here's Siftestad. That hit the antenna again. So another Hawaii point on a hitting error by Tanner Siftestad. Timeout taken by the Tritons.
And again, the Tritons struggling a little bit offensively, hitting at 061 right now as a team.
Kevin Ring, in his 11th year, earned his 75th career win. With that victory over Princeton on Wednesday, was the 2009 MPSF Coach of the Year, but it's a difficult job. UCSD, one of just two Division II members of the MPSF, Cal Baptist the other. Take a look at tonight's Jack Fact. Off to a fast start indeed. Hawaii's 6-1 record is the best start to a season since 2005, and only the 1980 and 1996 teams were able to start the season with 7 consecutive victories. We commented in Game On, Lisa, that this year's schedule for Hawaii when it comes to the ranked teams in MPSF play, a little more backloaded. So is this sort of an indication of Hawaii taking advantage of a somewhat thinner opening portion of the schedule?
Well, I definitely think they're taking advantage of a thinner opening schedule, but I think it's very appropriate for this team. You lose two middle blockers, Taylor Averill and Davis Holt, just incredible players, All-Americans, honorable mentions. They've been in the program for 4 or 5 years apiece, and now you got to put players who don't normally play middle in the middle. I love that they started with a lighter schedule. Build the core, get the confidence. You know, you got 4 returning starters in this team, and they're going to have to crescendo is what they're going to have to do.
Well, they're second in the MPSF, 5th nationally in hitting percentage are the Rainbow Warriors. Tops in the nation, and largely because of that guy right there, Jennings Franciscovich, tops in the nation in kills per set and assists per set. So, yeah, they're finding some footing, and you're right. They're taking advantage of this early portion of the schedule layout, perhaps, but it probably will benefit this team greatly going forward with all of the moves and transitions that Charlie Wade had to instill.
I think it was smart coaching and smart scheduling.
One of those guys making the transition to the middle position, Hendrick Mole, serving out of the timeout, but he sends it into the net.
Cardinal sin after a timeout. You got to keep that baby in. That's all because the libero is not allowed to serve in men's volleyball. Women's volleyball, libero serves. Men's volleyball, the libero does not serve.
Siftestad with the serve. Zarkovich, beautiful pass. He'll get the set for the back row, and he unleashes a bomb.
And that, Vic, if you will, I'll tell you, the tempo of that was perfect. Low, and Ziki just annihilates that ball into what they call the five box. Howard could not control that ball.
The 16th player to surpass 1,000 career kills here at Hawaii. Brooke Sador was the last one. So They've been coming in succession here for Hawaii. Schmidt on the outside. Von Tilburg couldn't pop it up. So UCSD hanging around. They've been around this 4 or 5 point deficit range for a good stretch here in the first.
Yes, they are, and they're doing a good job. And again, I think their offense is really what's hurting them the most. Again, hitting at 0-8-8 right now as a team.
Schmidt, the soft serve, two-handed by Faye. Faye will get the set on the outside. Overpass on the dig, and then the roof. It was Shane Beamer putting up the blockade on Ian McKellar.
And Ian McKellar, a lefty out of England, just thought he had an opportunity, but not that time.
So three total blocks for UCSD to match Hawaii. And it's a 3-point differential. Von Tilburg from the right side.
That's just a great set. Jennings Rankovich just sets it out there on the back right there. And Stein just annihilates that ball.
Von Tilburg now with 3 kills on 9 swings. Zarkovich leading the way for Hawaii. 4 kills, hitting 429. Served by Faye. Great pass by Schmidt. Outside it goes to Colbert by the triple block. One-handed diving save, Kanetake. Von Tilburg couldn't close. The save by Howard. And pinballed around on the Hawaii side after the second touch dump shot by Miloš Stojčić.
Kobe Kanetake, just an unbelievable one-arm dig here. He's in the right place defensively. Pops it up. Not only does he pop it up, but it's completely playable. And then on the very next play, he actually overread the play. He actually beat the ball to where it was going.
He and the opposite libero, Tanner Howard, both named in the preseason to the watch list for the inaugural Eric Shoji Award, which is given to the nation's top libero, presented by Off the Block. What an honor, not only to be nominated for that award, I'm sure, for these two liberos, but for an award to be named after one of Dave Shoji's sons.
And it's an inaugural, right? So yeah. They would be the first one to actually win this award. And Eric Shoji, of course, representing the Olympic team on the men's Olympic team as the libero.
There's McKellar with the serve, and it's an ace. Well timed as that gets Hawaii to 24.
And the lefty serving from corner to corner, a jump bomb.
That's one thing that has transpired because of the move for McKellar and Mole to the middle. Now you have two middles who can absolutely score points from the service line.
It's really nice to have middles that can serve tough like that.
Colbert off the block and out. So this one not done here in the first just yet. 20 serving 24 coming up, and still Aloha Ball here in the opening stanza for Charlie Wade's crew. Charlie Wade, 3 wins away from joining the Century Club as a head coach. He's 97-80 here, and this is 7th year as Hawaii head man.
Looking for number 100.
And a good start as Zarkovich puts it down. He's got 5 kills. Hawaii takes the opening set, 25-20. Good start for Charlie Wade and his crew. 5th-ranked Hawaii winning the first.
Big Island Candies, the perfect place to find the perfect gift. Visit them at their flagship store in Hilo, at Ala Moana Center, or online at BigIslandCandies.com to see their amazing selection, including delicious chocolate-dipped shortbreads.
Well, Kobe Kanetake doing Kobe Kanetake things in that first set. He was flying all over the court. 7 digs in the opening stanza, Lisa, as Hawaii takes game one against UC San Diego 25-20.
Well, there are his fan clubs, all of his family here, I'm sure, watching, staying close. Kobe Kanetake just all over the place. Again, he's in the top 10 digs for career digs. He made that last weekend here as a Warrior. He's 6th all-time as a Rainbow. The guy's amazing out of Moanalua High School. It's almost like he gets better with each game that he gets out here.
We've said it a multitude of times, and there are some fantastic players in every MPSF match on both sides of the net, but Kobe Kanetake, probably the smallest of the bunch at 5'8", is, in my opinion, one of the few who just by himself is worth the price of admission.
No, absolutely. What I do a lot when I'm watching these games is I'll pick one player and just follow and watch them. Not the ball, but just the player. You can learn so much by watching him on the court. It's unbelievable.
Had season tickets to UH volleyball when he was 6 years old, so he got acclimated very early on. And that was when Vernon Podlewski was doing his thing as one of the great defensive players for Hawaii. And Vernon Podlewski ended up helping to recruit Kobe Kanetaki to the program.
You know, small island world of volleyball. And you know, they list him at 5'8". Right?
You're suggesting what?
Well, I'm not totally sure. I mean, I know all the other guys are 6-plus above, but Kobe has a size thing going on. He looks about, well, maybe, I don't know. What do you think?
I'll give him the benefit of the 5'8 listing.
Yes.
You see the giant Kobe Kanetaki head in the background.
Let's see if they go after him. In talking to the coach earlier before the match, he said, we have to learn how to serve in the seams. Hawaii's passing team is so good.
And that was a well-executed transition there for Hawaii as the set went middle to Hendrick Mull. And the Rainbow Warriors off and running.
Perfect pass by Kupono Fei, allowing the middle attack. Hendrick Mull doing a nice job in the middle with 3 kills so far this evening.
See in your screen, Brian Zhu, 6'6", redshirt sophomore out of San Diego, in the match here to start this second set. The Tritons get the point, and Zhu now retreating back to serve.
And I think that Ring's just trying to look for somebody who can help spark his team, maybe like Schmidt did against Princeton.
That went into the net. Yeah, Zhu has appeared in 5 matches so far this season with 3 starts, was an MPSF all-academic selection last year. He is a bioengineering major.
I think this team has the most academic MPSF members on it of anybody.
As Beamer hit that one into the twine, so it's a point for Hawaii.
And again, the Tritons really struggling offensively. A lot of unforced errors at the net.
Tritons preseason pick to finish 12th out of 12 in the MPSF. Of course, coming off of the winless conference campaign last year, but again, 6 returning starters. One of them, Tanner Siftestad. Head coach Kevin Ring telling us, hey, last year was probably the youngest team I've coached in my 10 years plus at UCSD. He says the message that I've been trying to relay to this team is being transmitted much better now because of the veteranship.
And he feels that the team itself is actually practicing at a much higher level. They were so young last year that he just felt like, gosh, every time out there was just a curveball being thrown at these youngsters. They've got a year under their belt. He's got some experience. And he knows they're still learning every time out there. He's just trying to find the right combination.
Ron Tilburg, still without a hitting error. 4th kill for him on 11 tries, hitting 364. Here's Mole. A little extra on that serve. Good pass by Schmidt. He'll get the set on the outside and tools the block.
Schmidt seeing the block, hitting high off of the hands with some heat behind the ball there. It's his 5th kill in 10 attempts.
So 3 serving 4. Here's Schmidt. Two-handed in the air by Fei. Gets the set on the outside. Big swing. And he goes off the fingertips and down. 1st kill of the match for Kupono Fei on his 5th attempt. At the season high, 13 kills, 7 digs. In our first televised UH men's match last week against Grand Canyon, that happened to fall on his 21st birthday.
That is a great birthday gift.
Shane Beamer providing the point for UC San Diego, and a little bit seesaw-like here in the early goings of set 2.
Yeah, Shane Beamer, again, watching him in warm-ups, he had a great warm-up Wednesday. There you see his stats against Princeton, did a nice job.
Pass by Fei and Franciskovic. That is where his leaping ability and his length comes in so handy. 6'5", we mentioned the hops, he touches 12 feet, and a pass that would be categorized maybe as a shank to some turns into an easy put down for Jennings Franciskovic.
That's what they call bettering the ball, and the defense has to identify that Franciskovic is in the front court, and he can do that.
And then he can be in on things like that, too.
That's right, triple block. Hawaii's blocking really, really well tonight. It's nice to see them getting in a lot of triple blocks in. They're reading the offense very well.
Largest lead of this second set. There's all three of those guys in the front row. With McKellar in the middle up on that last one. Served by Faye outside. Here's Colbert, triple block up again, and he's able to eschew the block for a Triton point. He's impressive to watch.
He really is. He's got some hops, and he sees the court very well. Here the set, they're setting him off just enough so that he can take a sneak peek. Colby Konatake getting a finger on that ball, but just could not recover.
Kevin Ring pointing out to us, it is Ian Colbert, not Ian Colbert. As McKellar, the southpaw, flashing some of his fire.
Nice to see the southpaw getting some action. You know, that middle hitting position is very tough. Not only is it very tough, but if you're left-handed, it's doubly tough. The timing, the connection with the middle, and it's a new position. He's an opposite normally.
Here he is serving, goes down the line. Good pass by Colbert. Cross-court set, goes to Siftestad. Ole, says Jennings Franciskovic right next to Hendrik Mohl.
And there you see it again. Hawaii's block really catching on fire, earning easy points. They're very disciplined up, very low and tight.
Timeout taken as Hawaii distancing itself early here in set two. 9-5, Rainbow Warriors. Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. Time to check out the First Hawaiian Bank top three individual assist leaders. Jennings Franciskovic topping the list, 11.57 assists per set. Second in the nation, in fact, in that category. He, along with Kupono Fei, playing for the U.S. Junior National Team at the Pan Am Cup and World Junior Championships this summer. And by all accounts, you can see some of that growth and experience from their off seasons in their games this year, as Brian Zhu got denied access by Hendrik Mohl solo style.
Hendrik Mohl's looking pretty comfortable there as a middle blocker. You know, you would not know that he's transitioned into this position because he looks like a completely different player.
Even Mohl has to smile about that last sequence.
He's shaking his head like, yeah, I got this one, boys.
And the ace, Ian McKellar. Tickles the tape for a perfect drop down.
And you know, that has got to be the most frustrating if you're on the opposing side of the net. That let serve, it just trickles over and you get the point. See if he takes off something, backs off this one just a little.
You can learn to perfect that, forget about it. He put some heat on that one, forces the overpass, and Jennings Franciskovic annihilates it.
I think he might have even surprised himself, a little celebration dance. I think that might have hit the two-foot line.
We're going to tag that with the Fujitsu air conditioning cool play of the match. They do that just for exhibition, to ooh and awe the crowd.
And you know what's scary is that he's the center.
And McKellar busts out another ace. The line judge initially signaled out, but the top official, Ron Stoll, he overruled him, said no, that was in. And so it's an ace for McKellar, the second of this serving sequence.
And that's a sixth straight point for Hawaii. There you see it, bouncing lines. He's having away from the back line right now.
13 serving five, and McKellar almost pegged one of his teammates in the back of the dome there, but they'll take that production. Certainly a very productive trip to the service line for Ian McKellar. By the way, the officials tonight, Ron Stoll up on top of the ladder, Dixon Chun downstairs, and Sam Montalvo and Ryan Scudder, the two line judges. Served by Colbert outside. It's Zarkovic through the block. Trickles around on the side of UCSD. Now it's Colbert from the back row off the block, kept alive by Siki. Gets the set on the outside. Diving one hand save, Howard over the net. Franciskovic on the second touch got blocked. Well timed by Schmidt.
And Franciszkowicz thought he could go for it. What you notice he's been doing is he's jump setting a lot when he's in the front court. This time, Schmidt saw him and committed completely with him. That's his man. He has to stay with him. He did an excellent job reading that play.
Franciszkowicz, who can be a very offensive-minded setter, there's no doubt about it. Back sets his mate, Stein von Tilburg, who goes off the block and down. Hawaii has UCSD doubled up here in the second.
And von Tilburg with his fifth kill. Hawaii hitting at 600 here in this set currently with seven kills and only one error.
So here is Jennings. Good serve, diving pass by Howard. Stiff to stab. That's dug up by Franciszkowicz. So Kanetake bumps set Zarkovic. Triple block up. Kept alive by Faye. Von Tilburg took something off. This rally continues. Bump set to Siftestad. The touch blocked back, but he pops it up. Outside set to Schmidt from off the net, and the set that time just wasn't in a position for Josh Schmidt to be able to do anything with it. And Hawaii first to 15. Timeout on the floor. Fifth-ranked Rainbow Warriors open it up. Welcome back. Make the dream of education a reality for our student athletes. Visit HawaiiAthletics.com and click on the donate button in the Ahahui Koa Nui Nui banner. See the driver's dance here. There is a promotion where the graphic of a car window is put up on the big screen here overhead, and the fans are asked to pretend as though they're driving. And I think only about 30% of them point their body in the right direction.
I think you're right. But the participation is absolutely hilarious.
Tanner Siftestad misses wide. That's his fifth hitting error. And Hawaii opening up its largest lead of this second set. They're up 9, 16 serving 7. Rainbow Warriors hitting 500 here in the second. Negative 071 for UCSD. That'll continue to plummet as Von Tilburg and Hendrik Moll combine for the stuff.
Well, what's happening is Hawaii's block has gotten really hot. They've blocked 8 balls so far, and it's a little intimidating. So the Tritons are trying to do different things, and they're either making unforced errors or they're hitting into the block, struggling again offensively.
So Hawaii by 10, Schmidt hitting negative 167. He comes out, and Kirill Rudenko, number 24 in for UCSD, but they go to Siftestad on the opposite side, who puts down the Tritons point.
Siftestad doing a nice job from that right front. He's got 6 kills and 17 attempts, but still only hitting at 0.
So Brian Zhu, the 6'6 sophomore, with the run-up serve. Pass by Kanetake, right on the dot. Von Tilburg, though, blocked. Siftestad got the gist of it.
Sure did, and they're turning their block on a little bit now. They're trailing. They really dug themselves quite the deep hole. They've got to be patient and hang in this match if they're going to try to get back in.
Grill.
Brian Zhu again slapping it into play. Pass by Kanetake. And that time Franciszkowicz tried to pull off the wondrous one-hand back set, but he wasn't able to do so.
No, he wasn't able to. The pass a little too tight, and this time Franciszkowicz is in the back court, so he can't pull over, and he cannot dump the ball over on two like he did previously.
It's a little run being put together by Brian Zhu behind the service line. And that one just missed the end line. Good call that time on the Olay move by Kobe Kanetake. 18 serving 10 here. Siki Zarkovic now retreating back behind the line. He and Von Tilburg leading the way in kills for Hawaii. They each have a handful.
Zarkovic also leading in service aces for this team.
Passed by Colbert. Middle set. And that's Shane Beamer putting it down for another Tritons point.
Beamer with his fourth kill, hitting at 500%, spreading the offense out a little bit. That's called a three set, moving it away, challenging the defense, the Hawaii blockers.
Another substitution as Brian Blaich, 6'2 freshman from Newberry Park, California, comes in.
He'll be taking over the setting duties in the front court.
He's got the killer wig to boot.
He does.
Overpass by Kanetake. Diving save von Tilburg on the swing. And Kanetake saving it for a moment. Out of press row, but to no avail. Good effort, as always, from number six.
You know, the chase and the hustle is quite amazing. Colby Kanetake actually climbs up onto the table, brings it back, and he is so disappointed that that ball didn't get back across the net.
So Beamer picks up that last kill. UCSD back within six. They go outside to Rodenko. That's blocked back, kept alive by Colbert. Now Siptestad off the touch, kept alive by Zarkovic. Set goes to Faye. Doesn't get it above the net. Point for UC San Diego. And they're on a little bit of a run. A 6-1 run, in fact, for the Tritons back to within five. It was a 10-point advantage just moments ago.
Well, you know, you got to give them credit. They are fighting out here, putting a little bit of pressure from the service line as well as with their blocking.
Pass by Faye. Middle set. That's Moore. Good dig by Colbert. Siptestad sets up Rodenko. Rejected.
Rejected by a three-man block again. Hawaii's block doing an awesome job getting outside, sealing the net. Low and tight, not being used at the net.
You can see the scouting paying off here for Hawaii. I mean, they've had triple blocks up a high percentage of the time here against this UCSD transition. Now onto the floor, Joe Worsley, we talked about in the pregame. 6-foot freshman from Moraga, California, makes the dig there. Set goes to Zarkovic. Howard with the save. Siptestad, right down in front of Jennings Franciscovic.
And you know, this setter has come in and his tempo is a little bit quicker. His ball outside and back is quicker. So what's happening is the transition ball is just quicker and Hawaii's defense not quite there.
14 serving 19. And Kirill Rudenko, one of two seniors on the roster, 6'5", from Moscow, Russia, with the serve. Back set, Zarkovic. Diving attempt by Howard comes up empty, and the Rainbow Warriors get to the 20-point plateau.
That was a much-needed side out, if you will. Zarkovic just hammering that ball. Howard just not able to control it. Athleticism there.
Six kills for Zarkovic. He leads Hawaii. Stein with the serve. Colbert off the top of the net, saved by Kanetake. Here's Faye with the swing, and a net violation is going to go against UCSD. They're going to get the leech on this one, so that's a point for Hawaii, and it is 21 serving 14. And we're going to have a timeout called by Kevin Ring. He's going to talk things over.
And you got to give Kevin Ring credit. You know, we talked about this a little earlier. He was actually a volunteer. And 9 years he was an assistant coach. But more than that, he was a team manager for a very long time. And then somehow he gets into this mat. Then he gets on the court, plays as a player at UC San Diego, then becomes a coach, an assistant coach, 9 years later, and then becomes the head coach. Then he gets named, you know, to all these different things. Lo and behold, on his own team right now, he's got two players that were actually doing the same thing he did. They were team managers, and now they're starters on his team.
Yeah, Tanner Howard being one of them.
Yep.
The very strong libero for UC San Diego.
And Alec Flowers, the 6'6 sophomore out of Mountain View.
Take a moment to check out the MPSF scores. From around the way, top-ranked UCLA remaining unbeaten with the win over CSUN. How about this thriller of a match? Long Beach State and UCSB, and the Beach pulling it off 15-13 in the fifth. BYU, UC Irvine sweep in favor of the Cougars, and Stanford taking down Cal Baptist. Well, the MPSF, as it is every year in men's volleyball, it is the cream of the crop, and Charlie Wade has talked about it. He says there are no nights off in the MPSF.
Absolutely no nights off. There's so much parity, it's almost ridiculous. You know, you look at the preseason poll with BYU at number one. They've lost, Pepperdine's lost everybody. Stanford way down at the bottom, now beating teams.
Here's the updated standings. UCLA still on top. Hawaii at 1-1. So Rainbow Warriors just getting this thing started.
Yeah, a little late on the go in the conference play, but they've got many games under their belt.
On Tilburg, go. That one just brushed up against the end line. And it's a service ace out of the timeout.
And that is an awesome serve. I'll tell you, Hawaii serving has really put a lot of pressure on the Titans. Tritons.
22 serving 14. Passed by Howard. Back set, back row. Goes to Siftestad, and he's able to handcuff Zarkovich.
I think that's got to be his favorite hit from the back court, a deep right side. He attacks that ball well, and he's been very successful tonight so far.
Match high 8 kills on 21 attempts for Siftestad. He's hitting 143. And a serve by Beamer. High and away, the set goes to Fay. Pulled the string in a net violation against the Tritons. And it's going to be another point for Hawaii. We're closing in on set two.
That's Ryan Blake. He's only a freshman, and I think it's almost like he's trying too hard. He just got inserted into this set as a setter, and up on the block is going a little bit too close to the net.
So Fay, 3 service aces to his credit coming into this match. Deals a good one on the second touch. Blake's trying to catch Hawaii off guard, but he missed the court wide. Good idea, execution not quite there.
Yeah, he's got the right mindset and the right hairdo, as you pointed out earlier. And it was open. Had that been, 10 inches the other way, it would have been in.
I'm so jealous of that salad on top of Ryan Blake's head as Faye sends that one long on Aloha ball here in the second.
Oh, we heard about your haircut excursions earlier today. Thank you for sharing.
Can't mess around with bad haircuts because you never know when it's going to be your last when you get to my age.
You do what you did. You put a hat on and you go to your nearest barber.
Here's the serve by Blake. Pass Bay outside Zarkovich through the block and down, and Hawaii locks up set two. So the Rainbow Warriors taking the first couple of sets, which means that they have an opportunity here on this Friday evening to open up and reach into the broom closet. Welcome back. Let's take a look at the McDonald's match statistics. Lisa, what do you see?
Well, obviously I'm going to look at the errors and the percentage. When you look at the Tritons, you see their errors. You got 19 errors and their kill percentage. What I love about Hawaii is their blocks. It is on tonight, as well as the serving. I like that they're going for it. They're serving with a lot of pressure behind the line.
So I asked the corner crew members, I'll ask you, how does Hawaii guard against any level of complacency in a match that tonight has otherwise been pretty easy for?
Well, I think you guard it by doing the same thing over and over. I think there may be some challenges ahead in this match, only because I'm looking that there may be some substitutions coming in, as Hawaii has really been in a nice flow, if you will. Everybody is participating. Their hitting percentage is high. They're doing little things well.
We want to send a shout out to a couple of our colleagues not here tonight, taking sick days. We mentioned Scott Robbs, Chris McLaughlin, get well soon. And also a very special shout out to a guy who has been covering this men's volleyball program and been an integral part of the transmission of information to the public, to the community, and that's Stephen Tsai of the Honolulu Star Advertiser, who underwent multiple bypass surgery here recently, and he is recuperating. We're following him on Facebook. He's one of those that posts a lot of updates and pictures, and so keep the selfies coming, Stephen. It means you're feeling better, and we wish you the best in your recovery.
Best to you all. May you all recover and get back to athletics.
Nainoa Frank getting the nod here in set three. He is a 6'5 freshman out of Kalaheo High School. And we're also going to see Brett Rosenmeyer, 6'5 freshman from Virginia Beach, Virginia.
In the outside hitter position, Nainoa Frank as a middle blocker. And again, these are the changes I had talked about, trying to get these kids some time, some opportunities in live games.
And it'll be an opposite side hit for Ian Colbert, able to get the point for UCSD. So for the first time here tonight, UC San Diego starting off a set in front.
Jumping out quick with the first point.
Their first lead of this entire match. Here's Colbert, passed by Kanetake. Franciscovic goes middle, and Nainoa Frank, welcome to the party.
And you gotta love that he goes right to Nainoa, and he establishes the middle. He's got a lot of confidence in him. It's kind of really opened things up for the pin hitters.
So much uncertainty with the graduation of Taylor Averill and Davis Holt and what would happen in that middle position. Some players who were expected to be there that weren't for injury and other reasons. Now, Charlie Wade appears to have not only a couple of starting middles, but a little bit of depth at that position as well, with Nainoa Frank and now Hendrik Mohl able to play something he's been a little more used to here on the opposite side.
Yeah, nice to see Hendrik getting back to that right front. I'm sure he's happy. I'll tell you again, that middle blocking position is a really tough position.
And so key in the success of any men's volleyball program, particularly in this MPSF conference. Zarkovic sends it into the net. And Alec Flowers, one of those guys you mentioned, Lisa, served as a team manager last year, was slated to redshirt, but then was thrown onto the active roster, ended up starting 9 of the last 10 matches as Frank gets dug up. That one two-handed over. One hand set to Frank. It will be a back row attacker call and violation against Jennings Franciscovic, who argues his point to Ron Stoll.
And very interestingly enough, here on the replay, we'll see he's up. He's actually bringing, actually it looked pretty clean from here, but that is such a judgmental call. There is no instant replay. No. We're going to review this. Maybe one day there will be. Right now, there is not.
Flowers, born in Geneva, Switzerland. And here's Rosenmeier on the outside from Virginia Beach. So the same area that produced one of the greats in Hawaii history, who's on the coaching staff now, assistant Josh Walker.
Well, there we go. Maybe Josh had a little nudge, wanted the Virginia Beach boy to get in there. But welcome to D1 volleyball for your first kill on the evening.
Nice job of Schmidt using the block to his advantage.
And Mohl will probably not let that happen again. Again, he's been in the middle all night blocking nails. And on that play, he completely got used. What we call tooled.
Siftestad to serve. 4-3. Passed by Kanetake. Franciscovic sends it straight up in the air to Mohl. Didn't get all of it. Save Colbert. Outside it goes to Schmidt. That's dug up by Zarkovic. Franciscovic high and away to Rosenmeier through the triple block and down.
And Rosenmeier, only a freshman, seeing the block, a low tight block, and hitting high off the hands for his second kill of the evening.
Second kill of the evening, eighth kill in his Hawaii career. A 4-year letter winner at Frank W. Cox High School in Virginia Beach. Nickname? Rosie, of course. Mohl, he did what McKellar did in the last set.
You gotta love seeing, again, the middle blockers going for the jump serves. And really, you know, McKellar played awesome from the backcourt. He had 3 service aces so far. Now, Mohl, welcome to the Service Ace Club on the evening.
5-4. And give it and then take it away for Hendrik Mohl from the service line. Already the 5th tie of this 3rd set. So the Tritons having the most positive and competitive of starts to this 3rd set by comparison to the 1st 2. Rosenmeier, the pass, gets the set on the outside against a triple block. Outside it goes to Colbert, and he just nudges it past Franciscovic and down.
And again, the tempo of the set for the Tritons is a little bit quicker. The hitter's getting there a little late and just bettering the ball using the outside hand of Jennings Frankovic. Franciscovic.
Here's Schmidt. That one sent long, and it hits the line judge. I guess that's when you know, as a line judge, for sure that it's out.
I think that's a first. I have never seen that. It almost looked like he was playing tennis. Here on the instant replay, you know, he wants to get involved in the game so bad.
It makes the call easy. 6-6. High and away it goes to Colbert. He vaulted off the trampoline on that one. He'll get a second try. And that one sails long again. Point Hawaii in 7-6.
A little unfortunately, Hawaii blockers, or fortunately, I should say, don't jump that high. He was looking for hands, and that was just way too high.
Now Rosenmeyer to serve. High, high toss. The pass by Howard. Put over on the second touch by Blake. Played off the net by Franciskovic, and Rosenmeyer sends it over. Colbert had the quick stutter, the approach saved by Mole. Outside set, Zarkovic off the block and out. Point, Rainbow Warriors.
And that was a great scramble play, all started by Hendrik Mole, playing in the right back position right now. He scrambles for that ball. And remember, Hendrik Mole is a beach volleyball player. That was a great read by him on that play.
Both his parents were beach volleyball players in Norway. His mom finished ninth at the 96 Olympic Games in Atlanta. Nobody up against Siptestad that time. And he took advantage. One of the very few times that a UCSD hitter has had that level of open court to work with.
And you got to compliment this setter, Ryan Blake, doing a nice job isolating him on the backside.
Served by Beamer. McKellar. Oh, the southpaw. It's tricky when you're on the opposite side of the net. It can be tricky for the setter, but that time Jennings was on the money.
That was a great connection by those two. His set is a little higher. He's a big guy, and again, the lefty in the middle. Very hard to defend that.
How do you defend that as a middle? I mean, you just have to be so aware.
You have to start in a whole different position. You almost need to train against it. You can't just pick it up in a live match. And very seldom do you see middle blockers that are left-handed. You usually see them as opposites, not even left-front players. They're opposite hitters. Opposite the setter is what I'm talking about, where they play right-front.
Ryan Blake came in the second set. To set, and his counterpart, Jennings Franciskovic, gets the kill on the little dump down.
And again, taking advantage, he saw nobody with him. He's tending to jump set when he's in the front court. Nobody jumping with him, he jumps and dumps.
Born in Chicago, Illinois, Jennings Franciskovic calls Westlake Village, California, the hometown now. And Siptestad, they have not really been able to find a consistent answer for Tanner Siptestad. Now 10 kills on 24 attacks for him. And it's a one-point set here.
He's hitting from all over the court, not only left front and right front, but also out of the back court. So he has been very hard to stop so far this evening.
Hitting 208 is Siptestad. Colbert tried to curl it in. Oh, he just missed.
Gotta like the energy they're going for their serves. We talked to the coach earlier, Kevin Ring, and he said, we have to serve tough. We've got to find the gaps against this Hawaii team. They're notably a very good passing team.
Zarkovic with the serve, pass Colbert. Oh, what, up two. Schmidt couldn't connect on it. Caught it fat. It's a point for Hawaii. And Kevin Ring again up off the bench shouting instructions.
There was a touch actually called. He called it, and Kevin saw that he had called it, and he went up, hey, wait, you called a touch, and he's saying, no, I didn't.
Now he's saying he didn't.
But he actually did call a touch, and I guess the decision was changed.
Well, the line judge is playing prominently here into the course of this third set.
No touch.
Schmidt. Big touch on the block there, but he goes off of the high hands of Nainoa Frank and out.
That's a big block. Frank and Wolf up there in the front court.
He's just joining us. Hawaii has made it look pretty easy so far, winning set one 25-20, 25-16 in the second. A little bit more competitive here thus far in the third. Mole tooling the block.
And you know, his timing just a little bit off. It a little bit, but he's so smart, he stopped himself, took a look at the block, and just put some heat on it and hit high and hard off the block.
He can absolutely bring the thunder if he gets into it. One of the hardest hitters in the country. If he gets one that's right for the taking, and a service ace. And I know a Frank, so he's made his presence felt along the net, and now doing so from behind the service line. 2013 graduate of Kalaheo.
at 6'5" and a freshman.
Right side, Siftestad missed wide. Going for Hawaii, and they get to 15 first. So despite the Tritons coming out a little bit more assertively here in the third, Hawaii up by a handful. Welcome back to the Stan Sheriff Center. The Rainbow Warriors up 5 here in the third and closing in on what could be their 15th straight win at home dating back to last year. You see Charlie Wade with the lefty sling. Now, for those just joining us, he did suffer a broken arm earlier this week. The stories have varied, especially if you talk to Charlie. But the true story is he was moving a couch at his house, stumbled, actually fell down steps and suffered the injury. But he's come up with a lot more cooler scenarios, I guess we could say, as Siftestad adds to his double-digit kill total.
Oh, yeah, Charlie Wade, you know, doing a nice job coaching his team, but also just looks a little painful. I think he's having fun with all of us when he's making up these stories.
First thing he said to me is like, yeah, I was skydiving. The chute didn't open. Luckily, I was wearing a helmet. As Brett Rosenmeier was able to slam it through the block and down. Second one he said was, yeah, Hendrick Mole, we got into an arm wrestling match. I won the right-handed side, but Hendrick got the better of me on the left-handed side, obviously. And here is Mole serving. Just missing the end line.
Mixing things up, he was jump serving earlier. He jumped an ace and then he jumped into the net, so he decides to go for the deep floater and just misses into the deep corner on that serve.
12 serving 16 as Josh Schmidt putting it into play. Rosenmeier, bit of an overpass, but that's what we're talking about with Jennings Franciscovic. In fact, Charlie Wade has said, Lisa, a lot of times we actually design our service receptions to look like that because he's a guy that can go up and get them.
Well, you know, it's a huge advantage to have a tall center in the front court that's so mindful, but also that he jumps well. And placement. Why play three if you can play two? Why play three hits if you can play two hits?
Beamer blocked back, kept alive. Tritons go outside to Colbert, bounces it off the block. Great save, Rosenmeier. Bump set to Zarkovic from off the net. And that had some smoke flying off of the tail of it. Ninth kill for Zarkovic.
And you gotta love this save. In the backcourt here, flying all over, communicating well. Zeki Zarkovic putting it away.
Served by Rosenmeier, diving past Schmidt, outside Colbert came swooping in, great dig, Kobe Konatake. Bump set across court to Zarkovic, took something off, chance now for the Tritons. They go outside to Colbert, and the set was just a little low, they wanted a touch and they get it. A touch by that Hawaii block, so Colbert can kill, and the point for the Tritons.
The setting, again, the tempo a little quicker to the pin outside, and you're gonna see a little bit more tipping or using the block when the sets are low and tight like that, because Hawaii has a huge block.
Shane Beamer with the serve. Bounced around on the Hawaii side, but ultimately it winds up nectar for Zarkovic, who pummels it.
He is having a night, let me tell you. He's got his gun loaded. That is his 10th kill in 18 attempts, hitting at 500.
He has now hit double digits in every match this season in the kill category. Stein von Tilburg, sitting on 5 kills, actually in danger of ending his own streak of the same variety. Here's Joe Worsley with the serve. Outside Colbert, blocked and roofed. Jennings Franciscovic saying, oh, no, you don't. Timeout, Kevin Ring, and UC San Diego. We'll take a break as well. The Rainbow Warriors closing in. Welcome back. Let's check out how it works, presented by Central Pacific Bank. Lisa, what are we looking at?
Taking a quick look at Franciscovic, the setter. He jumps setting there, and there you see the opposing going up for the block, committing to him in the front court. But now on this next play, he likes to jump set. He's here in front court, number 10, is back to us, and he jumps and dumps, but nobody on the other side commits to him that time. That's how it works.
As we return to live action, Colbert sent one almost into the seats behind the cheerleaders over here at the left end of the arena. So it's another point for Hawaii. They're up 21-13, and we have another substitution for the Rainbow Warriors. Dalton Solbrig coming in, 6'6 freshman from Lindenhurst, Illinois. A serve by Joe Worsley. Colbert against the triple block. Worsley the diving layup. Jennings. Oh, he went into attacker mode and puts it down.
And you know, you've got to give credit to Joe Worsley there. The guy comes in, this is his fourth serve, but he defends that ball like a libero, which is what he was recruited for nationwide. There's his mom and dad flew in today to see their son play. And he's putting a lot of pressure.
Oh, he forced the overpass, but it was better timed on the joust at the net by Ryan Blaich. So he'll return back to serve, 14 serving 22. But we've seen now the reserves for Hawaii getting some action. Charlie Wade going to the bench. How valuable is this at this stage of the season for this Rainbow Warrior team?
Oh, no, it's huge. They need to get their time. They're the ones that are pushing the number one team day in and day out. And it just goes to show you the confidence and the faith that Coach Charlie Wade has in these young men. You know, they're all most highly recruited class in the nation.
Siskovich again called for the violation as a back row attack. He's trying to get an explanation. Second time he's been pegged for that here in this match. And seems like he disagrees, obviously. What do you think?
Well, he obviously disagrees because he walked away and he said something and he just got a yellow card. So Franciscovic getting a yellow card, excuse me, from the upper ref. Not a happy camper right now.
I haven't seen too many of those issues.
No, you don't see them often, but you know, questioning a ref is not necessarily going to change their mind.
Outside, here's Siki off the block and out. So Franciscovic, who just moments ago was an opposite pin attacker, we saw him put it down. That time, the more natural setter's role, and he set up Zarkovic, who continues to have a discussion with Ron Stoll.
Zarkovic is the floor captain. He's the only one who's permissibly allowed to talk with the head.
Part of the reason why Franciscovic was given the yellow, and he sends it into the net. So for Hawaii, you got a little bit of this peripheral stuff going on, and obviously Charlie Wade's thinking, all right, let's just focus and get these last 2 points, and we can get out of here. They have a day off before round two of this matchup on Sunday.
And it'll be their last Sunday, one of their last Sunday matches of the year.
Ian Colbert with the serve, tickles the tape, Rosenmeyer the pass. Franciscovic outside, it goes to Solbring.
Solbring getting the kill, and the bench goes completely crazy. That's awesome to see. So much support from the sideline for this young man.
So another freshman making an impact, and it is Aloha Ball. They rise. Here's the stand sheriff, center Zarkovic. Middle set, and that's Flowers puts it down, and that will postpone things, at least for the moment.
And Howard doing what he does best, passing nails all night. He has been nails, the libero for the Tritons, passing on target.
Hawaii looking to improve on its 6-1 overall record already, best start since 05. Luke Lamont. In the serve, pass Zarkovic. He gets it from the back row, puts it down. And on Aloha Ball, Zarkovic bidding Aloha to the Tritons as Hawaii wins e kahi e lua. Aloha here on this Friday night.
Zarkovic just having a fabulous night tonight, 12 kills. They just had their way all night long, a great team effort.
12 kills for Siki to lead the way, hit 476. So yeah, monstrous night, as you mentioned. How about the efficiency of Hendrik Mohl? 5 kills on 7 swings, no errors. He had 714. Stein von Tilburg, interestingly enough, for the first time this season, not reaching double figures in kills. The freshman with 5 kills, hit 267.
15 attempts, but just not putting balls down like he has been earlier in the season. But hey, that's okay. The win came. And what you gotta love about the team effort is that other people rose up and contributed in different ways.
And either way you look at it, it's a sweet victory for Hawaii. And it's also their 15th straight on this floor going back to last year. So the confidence can continue to swell for this squad.
And that's exactly what they need, having a couple of new players in, playing in your home court, getting the confidence, growing together as a team. There is a definite advantage of playing here at the Stan Sheriff.
So even the one-armed Charlie Wade and the Rainbow Warriors getting it done here on this Friday evening. Again, the rematch will be on Sunday. Don't forget, tomorrow we got Rainbow Warrior basketball, and they're expecting close to capacity, if not a sellout, as Hawaii plays host to Long Beach State. We are waiting to see if Ryan Kalesuji can get a word here with Charlie Wade, and now Charlie will make his way over to Ryan. So let's send it over there now. Ryan, what's up?
Thanks, Kunal. Well, Charlie, got to be happy and pleased with the way your team came out and played tonight.
Yeah, really am. You know, had a nice week of practice, so it was good to see us come out and get off to a good start.
You know, this is the second match in a row. In that third set, we've been able to see some of your bench. What have you been thinking about trying to get these players in? Is it more just trying to get them game time experience?
Yeah, and I mean, they work really hard every day, and they're good players, you know, so really want to give them a shot. And, you know, for a while there, I thought, you know, Brett Rosemeyer was 7-for-7 in the building. But he said they're good players, they're working hard, and just need to get them on the court and let them, you know, some payoff for all the hard work they've been putting in there.
Obviously, there's another match with UCSD coming up on Sunday night, but next weekend it's UCLA. How do you keep the team motivated and not look ahead to UCLA knowing that you have to play this team again?
Yeah, I mean, I think we got enough veteran guys in CMPSF that you just can't do that, you know. So it's we'll be practicing again tomorrow and focus for San Diego on Sunday.
Final question. You are now on the disabled list with maybe a few members. If you want to explain maybe what exactly happened to your arm here, Charlie.
Well, I got a whole list of things I could say what it is. I think I'm going to go with, I was arm wrestling Hendrick Mole. I beat him with my right hand and he wanted to go left, and then we were in this epic battle and he just broke my arm. So
there you have it. Breaking news. Hendrick Mole versus Charlie Wade. Looks like it was a deuce. Back to you guys.
Thanks a lot. Yeah, Ryan, that's the one he's going to go with for sure. And I like what you did there, Ryan. Breaking news. Well done there, buddy. Figuratively and literally, Tanner Siftestad getting the player of the match nod as we bring you the Bank of Hawaii players of the match. 11 kills for him, hit 192. Siki Zarkovich, 12 kills, hit 476. So Hawaii improves to 7-1 now, 2-1 in the MPSF. Tritons fall to 3-6. They're 0-5 in conference. And of course, again, the rematch on Sunday. And then UCLA coming in. You know a couple of the players on that team, don't you, Lisa?
I do. I got some love on that team.
Some ma'a lineage, yep, will be coming in along, yep, with the Bruins. So obviously things will step up for this Hawaii team. But handling business, so far so good here in 2016.
Absolutely. You know, the team, I feel, watching them courtside and being allowed to work with you and sit so close, I feel they're getting better and better every time out, especially the middle blockers. We talked about that since the beginning of the season. The middle blockers have to, you know, they got some catch up to do. They're playing out of position. But tonight was a really great reflection of those middle blockers, not only the front court hitting, but blocking and from the service line. They are doing a great job.
And yeah, so one more opportunity here against UCSD to maybe further improve, build on the confidence, because they're going to need a whole lot of confidence when Michael Ma'a and the UCLA Bruins, the top ranked team in the land, unbeaten as they remain tonight, comes into town. All right, that'll do it for us, or at least for you, Lisa. I'm going to go join the corner crew, but thanks. Great job tonight. Great working with you. Post-game show coming up, folks. Hawaii wins by way of a sweep, 25-20, 16-17.